Australian Rotary Health is the catalyst for education, research and awareness, ensuring a happier, healthier quality of life for every Australian. Australian Rotary Health awards medical and health research grants to researchers all over the country.
My name is Ron Rapay. I'm a professor of psychology at Macquarie University, and I'm the director of the Centre for Emotional Health. Within the Centre for Emotional Health, there's a whole team of us that does a lot of work looking at understanding more about the nature of emotional problems such as anxiety, depression, related difficulties. And a large part of what we do is developing new treatment programs and developing scientifically proven treatment programs. And we look at those right across the lifespan from birth through to older age. Probably a large part of our bread and butter, if you like, or a large part of what we're known for is work that we do with younger people. So a lot of treatment programs that we do for anxiety in children and teenagers. In general, Australian Rotary Health has provided funding for several projects and it's helped us get a much better understanding of the nature of anxiety in children, and has helped us to start to come up with new ideas for treatments, for new innovative types of treatments. And so that these sorts of treatments will eventually find their way into mainstream practice and will help anxious kids across Australia and really across the world. A lot of the treatment programs that we produce at the Centre for Emotional Health are in fact translated into several different languages, and they're used around the world and across Australia, of course, by many different therapists. So our programs are already being translated into real practice and are being used in real practice. And Australian Rotary Health, with the funding they've given us, has really contributed to that. The research in Australia and the surveys that we have tell us that about one in five people has a mental disorder. And mental disorders are something that have a lot of stigma attached to them. And so traditionally, the funding and the knowledge base we have about mental health lags far behind a lot of other areas, such as cancers and heart disease, etc., where we have some fantastic knowledge now. And so investing in mental health and investing in Australian Rotary Health helps us to stay at the cutting edge of scientific understanding of mental disorders, helps us to understand them better, and in turn then to develop better treatments and help more people across Australia who suffer from these very difficult and not widely talked about types of problems.
Australian Rotary Health awards PhD research scholarships to young researchers working in the field of mental illness.
Well, my name's Felice Jacker, and I'm a research fellow, a principal research fellow at Deakin University within the School of Medicine, and I'm a psychiatric epidemiologist. In my particular case, my area of interest is psychiatry and mental health. So I look in particular at depression and anxiety, and they're called the common mental disorders. So depression, for example, accounts for the largest burden of disability in the developed world. So it has a very negative impact on individuals, on families, communities, and, you know, the public health system as well. And it was Rotary then who gave me my scholarship to do my PhD. Now, my PhD took 3.5 years, as PhDs do, and I interviewed, I interviewed over 500 women from around the Geelong area, very large sample of women who are very representative of the Australian population. They're right across the age range. And I looked at their diets, I did interviews with them about their mental health, and then I looked at how those two things were related. And what I found was that women who had healthier diets were much less likely to have depression and anxiety. Those who had more unhealthy foods in their diets were more likely to be depressed and have these sort of symptoms of mental health problems. And happily, that research, the main paper from my PhD ended up being published on the front cover of the American Journal of Psychiatry. Mental health research receives a far smaller proportion of the funding for medical research in Australia. And Rotary's role in addressing that lack has been absolutely critical. But for my research career in particular, it's been absolutely essential, and I'm forever grateful.
Australian Rotary Health also awards PhD research scholarships in other medical fields funded in conjunction with local Rotary clubs.
Hi, my name is Matt Carlino. I'm a medical oncologist and also a PhD student at the Westmead Institute for Cancer Research. So my research project is looking at our new treatments in melanoma. In the last few years, there's been a development of a few new treatments in melanoma, which are much more successful than prior treatments. These treatments have very high response rates in patients. So most patients get, they improve with these drugs, their pain goes away, their symptoms go away. But unfortunately, at some point in the future, the drugs stop working and the cancer regrows. This regrowth is due to resistance, and our group is trying to work out what the mechanism of this resistance is with the hope of trying to overcome the problem. So the reason I decided to enter this field of research is that during my clinical training as an oncologist, I was involved in the clinical trials of these new drugs, and we found we had a lot of patients who were unwell who dramatically improved when they started these medications, which was really exciting. The downside was that we saw these same patients months later become unwell and get sick again. And that really gave me the passion and drive to work out why that was happening and how we can prevent that from happening, or at least delay that from happening. One advantage of the financial support the community gives to Australian Rotary Health is it allows many people to be involved in many different fields of medical research. And it often supports junior people just starting out in their research career. So I think there's a lot of bang for that buck by supporting multiple junior people.
Australian Rotary Health awards Indigenous health scholarships to students studying a wide range of Indigenous health-related professions.
I'm doing a Masters of Audiology at UQ. I'm a mental health nurse, so I think that's awesome that everybody that I can hear is interested in mental health. I work at the Royal Brisbane in the eating disorder unit there. I hope to help the kids outback Queensland with the Deadly Ears program through Queensland Health.
I got accepted into the Masters in Mental Health by Professor Don Gorman, so at the University of Southern Queensland. So I'm just going from that and moving into the mental health stream, and I want to be there for my people. I want to be able to help them and also identify in their own lives what are the issues, what do you need to make yourself better, you know?
I am studying a Bachelor of Midwifery at Griffith University. I have the Indigenous Scholarship, the Rotary Health Scholarship, and it has been amazing for me. It's been such a help to get me through everything. I'd really like to get some kind of traditional birth attendant training in so that women, elders, grandparents, aunties, everyone who is interested in that can be trained in that, so then women can then birth on their country instead of having to birth miles away from where they're born.
Every midwife, or more broadly, every health practitioner that we graduate who's an Indigenous person is going to make a difference to the lives of Indigenous people in our countries.
Australian Rotary Health awards rural medical scholarships to both doctors and nurses studying in remote areas.
I'm Jamie, I come from Sale, and I am doing my grad year as a midwife and a nurse, RN. I've come from Sale, so I travelled to Churchill to do my uni for 4 years, and now I'm at the Sale Hospital and hopefully stay here next year after my grad year's finished.
My role in the East Gippsland Regional Clinical School is I'm an administration officer, supporting the academics here. We run a program for medical students. We have undergraduate medical students and graduate entry medical students. The hospitals are always short of nursing staff and qualified doctors and allied health professionals, no matter what part of Australia, it's in rural and remote areas.
Getting the scholarship is really beneficial because it allows me to stay in this area, and it helps me be able to work as much as I need to be able to consolidate all my skills and put all my theory into practice.
Australian Rotary Health can offer these scholarships, which really helps the people stay. So the community benefits, the hospitals would benefit, of course. If the hospitals benefit, then it flows back into the community again. It's a two-way street.
Australian Rotary Health hold annual fundraising events, a fun way to raise money for health research. The Great Australian Bike Ride was a 9-stage ride around Australia. State bike riding events are held annually to raise money for Australian Rotary Health. Annual Rotary Golf Days highlight the importance of funding into mental health research. You might also have the opportunity to have a round of golf with Michael Klim, an Australian Rotary Health Ambassador. Australian Rotary Health's largest fundraising event is HAT Day, a community event to spread mental health awareness. HAT Day is a day you and your Rotary Club can promote the importance of health research. The day also gives vital support to people suffering from mental health related issues. Remember, mental health is not something you want to keep under your hat. Australian Rotary Health, supporting healthier minds, bodies and communities through research, awareness and education. Let's ensure every Australian leads a healthier life.